On Thursday, January 21st, the City of Portland, with Conbit Sante and WGME Channel 13, teamed up to hold an on-air telethon to raise money for the relief efforts in Haiti. In just a few days, they were able to pull together this effort with a goal to raise $50,000 with just the help of volunteers, no overhead, with 100% of the money to be immediately released to provide the needed medical supplies. Former City Councilor Peter O'Donnell, along with several others and Kim Block from WGME, spearheaded this mission. Here's what Peter had to say.
Well, this is really, in all of the sayings, we're thinking globally and we're acting locally. Conbit Sante has been in existence for a good 10, 12 years. This is a group of health professionals have been going over to CAP Haitian Haiti for all that time. The sister city adopted CAP Haitian as a sister city in 2003, City of Portland. And since then, we've been going over and bringing lots of relief. Health professionals have been going over and doing training, lots of supplies, and help with buying medications and providing other health services. What this is doing is this is providing immediate relief for the earthquake victims and help by materials, supplies, things that are needed. 100% of the money that's gathered here will go over and help our sister city. CAP Haitian, interestingly enough, is one of the only portals through Haiti at this point to get supplies and of all kinds of different varieties. And this is going to go over and help CAP Haitian help to rebuild that country. We formed a sister city relationship with CAP Haitian in 2003. And since then, we've had a formal recognition and a number of city people have gone over there to visit CAP Haitian. Nathan Nickerson, who's the executive director of Conbit Sante, is a former public health official for the City of Portland, and he's over there right now providing supplies, relief, and his professional, he's a doctor in health. We put this all together on Monday afternoon. We called WGME, Kim Block immediately endorsed the idea, and from there we've just been running, and we will until after 7 o'clock tonight. Former Mayor Jill Dusan was one of the organizers. We've had the police chief, we've had the mayors come in, we've had city councils, we've had community leaders, we've had people who've never gotten involved in anything like this before, and it was somewhat shy about the cameras being on them. But they just want to get in and try to help us raise money for Haiti and make a difference over there immediately. 5 o'clock this morning, we went on air. At this point, we've raised about $32,000, and it's our sense we're going to top $50,000 by the time the day's over. The response we're getting from people is whether it's $10, one gentleman walked in this afternoon, wanted to give a contribution, gave $5. We have people given $100, we have people who have given $500, we've had a couple $1,000 donations. We're getting the whole variety of donations, and we have over 450 donors at this point. So it's a real great community response, Bill. We just want to thank the people of Portland and the people from Greater Portland who really have stepped up to help this effort. It was put together in 4 days, and the people of this community have responded in a huge way to make a difference in CAP Haitian and Haiti and to help the people in Port-au-Prince.
For Community Update, I'm Bill Blood.